Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you this morning. What a great day and a great privilege to be in your presence. As we look up to you again today to do that which you have proposed to do in this place, which is to impact souls with the option to function, we ask today that not just those who are graduating, but everyone here will taste of that impact in the name of Jesus. Before the keynote speaker comes up this morning, the theme for this program is riding on eagle's wings. Amen? And I'll just say a few words by way of introduction. We read this morning from Deuteronomy 32. And I'll start from verse 9. It says, "For the Lord's portion is this people." We are God's portion. You know? That's in the whole world, God chose a people to himself as his own. And what a privilege to be among such a people. "For the Lord's portion is his people. Jacob is the lot of his inheritance. He found it in a desert land." Can I hear you say a desert land? So it doesn't matter where you are. Let God find you. The story will change. Amen? "He found it in a desert land. In a waste howling wilderness." But then look at the next word. "He led him about." Verse 10. "He led him." When you submit your life into God's hands, then God begins to lead you. He begins to guide you. He begins to direct you. He begins to take you from place to place, from experience to experience. "He led him about. He kept him." That is, as God is leading you, he also keeps you. That's why I said, "When I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil." Why? Because God is with me. So no matter your experience, many times some people, because of what you are going through, you think perhaps, "How can God be there?" Oh, he's there. Oh, he's there. And he's keeping you in the midst of it. A lot of us don't want to go through experiences, but experiences, those experiences, they have their purpose also. "He kept you as the apple of his eye." And look at verse 11. "As an eagle steereth up our nest, fluttereth over our young, spreadeth abroad our wings, and taketh them, and beareth them on our wings." The same way, that's what verse 10 says, so the Lord did lead him. And we're going to look much more into that episode this morning. What the eagle does, that's what it says. The eagle is the mother of all birds. Amen? Fly alone up there. Fly above the storms. But the eagle was never born an eagle. Grammarians use the word eaglet, right? Eaglet, one thing they like is to stay in the nest. Comfortable. But then the mother eagle comes, you know the story, troubles them until they know how to fly. Take them to experiences, near-death experiences, to get them to fly. And when they start flying, they are up there. Amen? God will take us such experience. That's why he said, so the Lord, verse 12, so the Lord alone did lead him, taking him through experiences. Some of those experiences that you think are going to swallow you, they are not there to swallow you, they are there to make you. Make you stronger, make you better, make you fly higher. If you walk with God, you will go higher. And we see that in the eagle, to stretch your muscles. When you see people with heavy muscles today, they didn't just arrive there. They went through various exercises, strenuous exercises, and pains to get there. And that's what we see of the eagle God. Amen. It's eagles don't fly with other birds. It is said that eagles either fly alone or fly with eagles. And that's why the Bible says, "He that walks with the wise shall be wise. A companion of fools shall be destroyed." Who are your companions? Who are you going with? Are they the ones helping you to rise or pulling you down? You got to check that. Amen. Eagles are high flyers. Eagles are highly focused birds. It is said that an eagle can see 5 kilometers ahead. And when an eagle focuses on a prey, nothing distracts him until he picks that prey. Highly focused. And that's why God expects us in the kingdom to be men and women of vision. And stay on your vision. commission, still on what he has you to do. We see a lot of these all through, and we learn. That's why I said, so, verse 12, I repeat, the Lord, just like the vehicle, the Lord alone did lead him, if you allow him. Another great character of the hippo is that eagles don't eat dead meat. You see vultures do that. Eagles don't. Eagles eat fresh, and God expects us to eat fresh. I don't mean the one they sell in Whole Foods. I mean the one in his word. Amen? Fresh meat. The Bible says they are new every day. Give us this day. His word is new every day. There are many of us believers today, as it was in the beginning, so is now, never shall leave me. We have left that error. You have to have desire for fresh meal from heaven. To be able to make impact in your world, to be able to go forward in your generation. Fresh meal. And that's why we encourage people to learn. Jesus himself said it, come and learn of me. When you stop learning, you start dying. Come and learn. Some people say, I don't want to be a pastor. What's, no, it has nothing to do with pastor. It has nothing to do with anything other than being the man, the woman God wants you to be. Amen? Equipped. Another thing to be a deacon is to love storms. The storms of life. When the storms come and you see other birds looking for where to hide, no, the eagle is enjoying. Because he's the ferocity of the storms that he rides with. So what is killing others and they are complaining? You are in the same and you are celebrating. Why? Because you allow God to make you. Why? Because you allow God to raise you. Why? Because you allow God to feed you. Why? That's what Jesus said. Follow me and I will make you. There is much to do in life. There is much to accomplish in life. That's why we celebrate graduates today. Amen? And we're trusting God that the anointing of God will come upon them. Like the Bible says in Revelation, he said, after the woman who had given 2 wings of a great eagle that should they fly. And lastly, the eagle knows is wiser than most birds. He sheds old feathers for new ones so that she can fly higher. And the Bible says that they that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. So renewal of strength is the wisdom of the eagle, if I put it that way. One of the things, like I always say, I hate most is when perhaps you hold a book in your hand, maybe a book on faith or healing or somebody, and another person sees the book, oh, I've read it. And you can't see the book on his life. A lot of us do that. Are you following me? I've been preaching now since 1984. And even if I have to preach a title that I've preached before, my people know, I don't just go pick my own notes, yet I have all my notes in electronic format. You have to check it again. You have to check it again. You have to build it again. Renewal of strength. What did you think you have learned? When did you learn it? Listen to me, I'm an electrical engineer, but if you bring me to wire your house, just go and get insurance. Get fire insurance. Because it will burn. I've practiced that one long this time. You understand what I'm saying? So I can't announce that in the certificate. I don't even think anybody, once they see my face, they say no. And you don't know, renewal of what? Strength. The meal of yesterday is there today. Get renewed by the word of God, by the word of faith, by the oppression of the Spirit. You can renew. He said, it satisfies my mouth with good things so that my strength is renewed like the eagles. Many of our Christian story has become stale. You need to refire it through knowledge, through learning. And that's why we are celebrating the graduates today. They tried. I told some of them the number of times they slept in the class, I have to remove it from the attendance. They tried, they managed. You know, that's the one thing the devil succeeded in doing here is to steal people's time from God. All of you know what I'm talking about. A lot of people want to serve God, but the devil has succeeded in doing that, and you have to fight it. It's you that must fight it and put priority to where it is.
You must fight. If you know it before you know it, it's God.
Some people started, they didn't finish. Oh, 4 months is too long, and before you know it, 4 months is over. You get my point? You have to give yourself to it. If you don't give yourself to learn, I always tell people, all of us here, when you pick your Bible, even if it doesn't work, and you pick your Bible, you want to read, you start sleeping again. The devil say, don't go there. And it's only the time that that thing happens. So do you notice that? If you pick newspaper now, in fact, it's like who breathes from somewhere. Keep on reading, you are okay. But when you pick the Bible, you fight it. Because that's where your destiny is. You have to give yourself to. Well, I'm not a preacher tonight. I mean, this morning. And I don't intend to be. I just want to introduce us to what we are here for. And to introduce our guest speaker today. Today is a guest. The church member, but he's a guest speaker today. Because he himself is an alumni of the school. Graduated from the school. And he's going to be bringing us the word of life. Some of you may be thinking the next graduation you are the one bringing the word. I didn't promise you that. Because the way Adrian was laughing when I said that, he's already projecting that I will be the next keynote speaker. No. Amen. Is Dr. Mulu Alem Agos. He's a businessman and a minister of the gospel. And he's here this morning with his cap that looked like somebody from my village. To bring us the word of life on riding on the eagle's wings. Please let's rise up on our feet and give honor to whom honor is due as we welcome the man of God. Good morning, church.
Good morning.
Please have a seat. Are you excited about the new year?
Yes, it's brand new year. Nobody touch it. Nobody messed up with it. It's fresh and brand new, and we're gonna use it for our own good. Amen. Be excited. Hallelujah. And then the Christmas is coming. I'm pretty sure I will be the number one to get a lot of gifts, more than anybody. Praise the Lord. May the Lord grant you with great favor this new year, with great happiness, with a strategic plan, with new revelation and understanding. The Lord is with you. You are not walking into 2009 alone. The Lord himself is going to be with you. He will support you, he will encourage you, he will lead you, and he will show you. He will show you. The Bible says on Jeremiah 33, chapter 3, cry out to me, and I will answer you, and I will show you. Remember, I will show you. It's there. The things you need, it's there. When you cry out to God, and God will show to you. Hallelujah. Let's pray. Father God, I pray in the name of Jesus, about 2019, we walking in and we believe it's going to be a year of miracle, sign and wonders, and with great provision. Father God, open our eyes, lead us, guide us, and show us what to do. Give us the strength, the understanding. In the name of Jesus, I pray. Amen. Hallelujah. Tell to your neighbor, it's going to be a great year.
It's going to be a great year.
Wonderfully. A year of miracle. A year of increase.
We have today our graduates, and then we can ordain two people as the pastors.
Give it to God.
Yes! And after this, we're going to call you pastor. Today, we're going to... I'm going to bring you the word of God from... my title is Riding on the Eagle's Wing. Hallelujah!
We're going to go to the Revelation chapter 12, verse 14. Hallelujah. But to the woman was given 2 wings to do what? To fly. Hallelujah. 2 wings. And to her place. To fly higher from our problems, we need wings. Tell to your neighbor, you need wings. To fly higher from our problems, higher place. And through teachings and trainings and mentoring, that's how we can fly higher. And those are the tools. The tools will help us to rise higher, to understand better. Through mentorship, mentors, they have been learning and understanding for a lot of years. We have to understand and learn from the mentors. Training and mentoring are a tools. The tools will help us to strengthen ourselves. Amen? Hallelujah. And counseling, education, coaching. Sometimes we neglect those things and then we hope things will be okay. But if we take the time to take education, if we submit ourselves to be mentored, if we humble ourselves to learn from others, even the Lord Jesus, he said, learn from me. Hallelujah. He's eager to teach us, to mentor us, to equip us. Hallelujah. Okay, let me ask you one question. If you go to the hospital, if you see 100 doctors, how many of them do you think they have been attending training or education? All of them. It's not a joke. To be a doctor at the hospital, they have to be trained. They have to be educated. They have to be mentored. Okay, if you go another question. If you go to the American camp soldiers, those army, how many of them do you think they are trained? All of them. You cannot arm someone who is not trained. They have to be trained. They have to be educated. They have to know how to use the machine guns and all the operation they do. How about the pilots? How many of them? All of them. They have to be trained. They have to be educated. And they have to know how to fly. But if anyone didn't go to training, do you think they can fly? How about if they didn't attend the school, do you think they're gonna fly? No,
doesn't happen by accident. So it's a key to learn, to be mentored, to be educated, to be coached. We have to be accountable. We have to be responsible for our life, which way to go. Our life is like a path. You know, if you drive your car to the north, guess what? Where are you heading? To the north. If you drive your car to the south, where are you heading? To the south. So our life is like a car. Wherever you drive it, that's what you're going to be. If you drive it backward, you are heading to. If you're moving forward, tell you never move. Move forward on your life. Move forward. Get some education. Get some training. Get some education to learn, to understand. The more you learn, the more you are wiser. The more you have tools. Matatapuro. You have to learn. You have to learn. Doesn't happen by accident. Okay, there is two kind of trainings. Formal and informal. Paul said on the book of Acts, chapter 22, verse 3. I had my education in this town at the feet of Gamaliel. He had what? Yes, everybody, we are amazed and marveled by Paul. But Paul was educated. He educated himself at the feet of Gamaliel. Education is a key. Second Timothy chapter 2, verse 15, Mr. Tyler. Study to show yourself approved to God. To who? Even to God. Not only to strengthen ourselves, not only to get tools, to get advantage every day so we can progress. But here it says, to show, approve yourself to God. Even God, he wants us to be serious. He cannot use someone who's not ready or committed himself. It needs commitment. Commitment and sacrifice. So God can use us. Mr. Dow, 2 Timothy chapter 3, verse 16 to 17.
Oh, chapter 2, verse 15, right?
No. Okay. Chapter 3, verse 16 to 17.
All right, so it says, all scripture is given by inspiration of God and is profitable for doctrine, for reproof, for correction, for instruction in righteousness, that the man of God may be complete, thoroughly equipped for every good work.
Amen. And this word of God is there. The whole counsel of God. To educate us and to make us complete on the understanding of and the word of God. Even Jesus, he said to his disciples, we always know, go ye to the word woman. But he told them before that, do not depart from Jerusalem. Why? Because until they get power, until they get equipped, until they are ready. He didn't say just go, but he told them, he was teaching them for a long time, and he even told them, stay in Jerusalem until you receive power from heaven. Because they need power. They need to be equipped before they can go. Revelation chapter 12, verse 14 says, for that woman. So the wings, we need the wings to fly higher, to soar, so we can see better, to have strength. Matthew chapter 16, verse 24. Jesus said to his followers, this is what he announced to them. He said, if anyone comes after me, he told them three things. If anyone comes after me, he said three things and I will finish. Number one, he has to deny himself. That means not living for himself, but living for God. Commitment. Being disciple to the kingdom of God. They have to. Like Paul, he said in Galatians chapter 2, verse 20, I am crucified with Christ. I don't live no longer for myself, but Christ lives in me. Hallelujah. That's denying. He said, yeah, number one, he said, you have to deny yourself. And then number two, he said, pick up your cross. Number three, follow me. Not one day, but day to day. So to follow Christ day to day is needs discipline, submission, and learning from God day to day. Let's rise up and pray. Praise the Lord. Father God, I pray in the name of Jesus for this graduate. Thank you for helping them to learn about you, about your kingdom. Father, anoint them, touch them, and use them the rest of their life. Father, I pray in the name of Jesus when they step into this new season. Anoint them. I put the favor of God upon them. Bless them. Bless the work of their hand. Bless their ministries. In the name of Jesus, I pray. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Jupiter, please take your seats. Hallelujah. Give me Genesis 14, 14. Thank God for the word of God we need to learn. Amen. Jesus said, come and learn of me. If you want to encounter rest, learn. Genesis 14, 14. We know about the story of Abraham The Bible says that when Abraham heard that his brother was taken, he hanged his trained servants. That's the key word. You have to be trained. Amen? If they give you a gun now, you may kill yourself with it. I've never fired a gun in my life. If they give me one now, it doesn't mean anything. So you don't know how to use it, I don't know. Do you understand it? But is the problem with the gun? No. But I'm not free. So you may have all the weapons in this world, but if you don't know how to use them, what happens? They still don't favor you. How many of you, oh, the blood of Jesus, the blood of Jesus, and nothing happens. It's a weapon, but you must know how to use it. Abraham and his trained servant. He didn't just give weapons to anyone, he gave weapons to those who are trained. That means he had more servants at home, but he said, if I go with this one, they may shoot me rather than shooting the enemy. Do you understand me? Because they were not trained. So he hanged his trained servants. And that's what Jesus did. He took a people with himself for a period of time through training. Some people think training is only when you sit in the class. No, there is formal, there is informal training. He mentioned the word mentorship. I worked with Bishop Oyedepo for many years. I went to Bible school in Winners for 1 month. But when I worked with him for well about 16, 17 years, and many of those times closely. So the things I learned were not learned in the Bible school. Do you understand me? They were learned through mentorship. Amen? So we have, God has provided means by which we learn for those who want to learn. Amen? So we have mentorship program, people learn from it. We have school of ministry program, people learn by it. But those who are interested in learning will always submit themselves to the process. It is said it is only those who ask questions deserve answers. Amen. Abraham is trained servants. We had a lot of apostles that God raised, but then Paul, a man of knowledge, came, and we saw the difference. You shall know the truth, and the truth shall make you free. Thank God for the word of God. Let's have the desire to learn. Amen? Let us have the desire to learn. Let us have the desire to ask questions, to find answers. The things I will never forget many years ago. That's when I still knew my engineering. Many years ago, I think 1990, thereabout. One day, my bishop called me on the phone. The lights in his house were dim, you know. And I was far away from his house. And there's a young man, that guy is in Britain now, who is an electrician that lives around his house. So I just called him. I said, Michelle, I said, go get there now, something is wrong. So he went there, checked a few things. He says, I can't get it. I said, no, once the light is dim, the metering line is out, check it. And he went to the box, the metering box, and oh yes, I put it, and there was light. If you don't know that, you will sleep in darkness. How many of us have car engines on the road and you are trying to check? What are you checking? Are you a mechanic? You don't know. You're checking a complicated matter. But the person who knows, right? You call the person and he comes. He doesn't even want to come. He said, no. Once you tell him what's going on, no, this must be this. Because he knows. He knows. That's what we're talking about. Making yourself available to learn. It puts you in a position of command. So very quickly now we're going to pray for the graduates, and I'm still trying to make up my mind for the two of them who said they want to be pastors, whether they are going to really be ordained. Oh my God. Sorry, I always put that one off. Whether they are going to be ordained as truly as pastors today. Amen? Jesus is Lord. That's my ministry. My ministry essentially is training men for ministry. And I've been doing that for a long time. Amen? Glory to God. So let's welcome our... Please, my wife, can I have this? Let's welcome our graduates very quickly. I call them one by one. If you hear your name, then you are truly graduated. If you don't hear your head, just sit down where you are. Amen? Eh? Hey, from where you come, it doesn't matter. We have Franklin Okorie. Please come here. We have Juliet Anosike. We have Harvey Tawaba. And I think that's all we have here. Or is there anybody remaining? Wami Osagenke. You didn't give me this name. What's that name? Was that what? Is that your surname? Because your middle name. Oh, because I know you gave me Wami, right? Well, I saw that when I saw your form. Well, these are those who made it from the class. We had quite a few more who are part of the class but they didn't make the cutoff point. What we always tell people, because we recognize the environment in which they are living, you can make up in another class and then you graduate with them. So anybody who is interested, that's why I printed out those brochures. Let's know if you have people from your church also who are interested. We always try to make sure that it's devoid of church. I take a school of ministry. The last set we had to were people from different churches like this. So we're always devoid of it. And our mission is to just train men for the work of the ministry. Amen? Glory to God. I said glory to God. Well, we have some pastors. I was expecting some of them. Please, sir, can you come? At least when I see that one, I know that means venerable or something, right? You supposed to say the name this again?
Kingsley Inti.
Inti.
Inti, yeah. From Ghana.
Because I wanted to say, I know Congo very well. That name is not from Congo. Oh, okay. We have also Pastor Folu here. She's someone that I've known for a long time. Please come forward. Did I say Folu? Sorry. I've known her from Nigeria before she found out. How did you come here? By road or by... Amen. Please let the man of God come forward up here. Please join me up here first. Amen. You didn't even pay for the cab, so I can collect them now. Yes? I told you. as you have ordained and enabled me, I stand today with this same authority as we consecrate and ordain these ones as pastors in the work of the vineyard, in the name of Jesus. It is the oil of God that makes the journey great. It is that oil to function that we put upon you today. Even for this consecration, he said that thou shalt anoint Aaron and his sons with this oil, that you may consecrate them, that they may minister unto me in the priest's office. By this oil today, Lord of heaven, we consecrate these ones, that from this day they will be able to minister as pastors on the day of God in the name of Jesus. That by this oil of God, you will become clothed with God's power, clothed with God's honor for glory and for beauty in the name of Jesus. From today, you will not lack what to say. From today, you will not lack the knowledge of what to do. That the work that God has committed into your hand, from this day forward, receive the grace to make it work in the name of Jesus. That from this day forward, receive the wisdom to make it work in the name of Jesus. Yes. By the power and the unction of God, we consecrate you today as pastors in this vineyard in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord of heaven. In Jesus' mighty name. Congratulations. Congratulations. Congratulations.